नमस्ते बच्चों, खुश रहिए। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक दैट इज बेसिकली बेस्ड ऑन योर कंप्यूटर नेटवर्किंग सब्जेक्ट, राइट? एंड योर टॉपिक नेम्स इज स्टडी ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड द डीएनएस, राइट? सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दैट टॉपिक्स, फर्स्टली आई इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। माई शेफ मुस्कान कुमारी एंड आई एम द फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोलॉजी and departments is my science and technology. Okay, so let's start that topics. I'm going to share the screens that will help you to ease in understanding that what are the various protocols, networking protocols that is used, and what do you mean by the DNS, and what is the working of DNS, right? So see here, this is the topic that study of network protocols and the DNS. DNS is one of the most important protocols that is mostly used in our daily life, right? So basically network protocols, right? Before the, starting with the network protocols, we just going to introduce that what is the protocol. Okay, in networking, a protocol is a set of rules for formatting and processing your data. What is the protocols? Protocols is basically a set of rules, and it is basically a procedures which follow all the rules or the set of the rules that is predefined to processing the data, that how the data will process from one to another. It means from sender to receiver, how the data will transmit, right? What is the role of transmissions of that data, and what are the protocols required to transmitting that particular data to the particular destination? Okay, so networking protocols are just like common languages for the computer, right? The computers within the any network may use vastly different softwares and hardwares. So however, the use of protocols enables them to communicate with each other regardless. Okay, you know that the computers within in any network, computers which are situated in any networks may use vastly different softwares and hardware, and two communication establishment between that hardware and softwares. There is a requirement of the protocols that enables these situations, that enables this condition, that the communication will be established between these two points of the devices or these two points, right? So on the internet, there are different protocols for different type of processing. Okay, suppose you are transmitting some data via the network layers, right? Then here at the network layer, there are some protocols that is basically related to networking protocols like IP address, DNS servers. And if you are using any processing the data via using the data link layer, then at that level, whatever the protocols can be used. So protocols are often discussed in terms of which OSI. Basically, the most protocols is basically used at which layer? Your TCP IP layer, and that is considered under the OSI models. Okay, so TCP and UDP, you are well known and well aware about these names, that what is the TCP and what is the UDP. So I'm not going to discuss this all. So TCP is basically used for transferring or transmissions of the particular data from source to the destination. The transmission control protocols and UDP is basically user datagram protocols are utilized to send network informations, okay, or you can say that network data, okay, to and from server and client applications. That what do you mean by this? That suppose the data with whatever you want to transfer, that you are the client and I am the server, okay, whatever you want to send me some data, then via which you transmit that data via using the transport layer or the network layer. Not the transport, basically the network layer. Okay, you are sending that particular data via using the network layer. So network layer is just play as a medium. The mediums from where you are transferring the data to the server. Okay, so this is basically that the transferring of the information by using the network. So you can also call that the network data from this client to the server. Okay, to server and from the clients. The primary contrast, yani primary motto, primary aim between these two protocols is that TCP utilizes a connection oriented transport. TCP is basically the connection oriented transport that you can easily transfer the data, and TCP is basically the connection oriented that the protocols is used in the TCP. So it is a connection oriented. It means that whatever you are sending the data to a particular server, to a particular receivers, the data must be sent to that particular receivers or the destination. So this is basically called the connection oriented. And connection oriented is basically what? There is a medium which is basically used to carry that particular data to the particular destination, while UDP uses a connectionless type of the communication. Okay, because what do you mean by this connectionless? It means that if it hasn't the IP addresses of the receivers or the destination, then if he has not the IP address of the receivers or the destination, then there is no any effect to the UDP. It sends the set of the data packets. Okay. Now, then again, UDP transmission doesn't make a listen-mate association and simply communicates its information to the predetermined organization. That predetermined organization, you are seeing here that predetermined organization is addressed. Whatever the address is predefined, okay, they will transmit the particular data to that address, to that organization, to that place, okay. Without not any checking of the received address. Okay, they are not going to check. Suppose he has sent some particular data to the previous destination, previous servers, and now you want to send this particular data to another server, another destinations, another receivers, but they basically not using the IP addresses of the particular receivers, and they will transmit the newly data or new data or updated data to the previous receiver's address. Okay, so it's called the connectionless. Now for a specific type of application and services, a TCP connection makes more sense. Okay, this makes the more sense because it is the connection oriented, and while other types are more efficiently provided by the UDP communications. Now, what is the basic advantages of TCP? The basic advantage of TCP is that transmission is much more reliable. Like transmission is much more reliable because it is the connection oriented, or the data packet is ensured delivered to that particular destination. Okay. The advantage of UDP is that there is no any connections, so it is much faster without the check and acknowledgement going on, right? It means that without checking the IP addresses of the particular destinations, they transfer the data to the previous addresses, and there is no any need to connections, but is also reliable. It is also less reliable than the TCP. Okay, the table, some common TCP IP applications are seen with the type of the protocols that basically use. Like, see here, there are the set of the protocols, and this is the common port which is basically used as the OSI layers or the TCP IP UDP model. First is your FTP. What is this? this is basically the file transfer protocols, and the common port number is this 20 or 21. SSH, this is basically used for the secure safe. Okay, the port is 22. Telnet, that is 23. SMTP, simple mail transfer protocols, this is basically used, and this protocol is basically used to mail some others. The port number is 25. DNS, which is basically, I will read after this, that is domain name service. This is the most important protocol. Okay, that is 53. TFTP, travel file transfer protocol, that's port number is 69. HTTP, hypertext transfer protocols, this is basically the protocols, whatever you want to type, like in URL, you are typing the HTTPS semicolon slash slash www.google.com. Okay, these are things. That port number is 80. POP3, that is Post Office Protocol version 3, port number 110. MNTP, NNTP, Network News Transfer Protocol, NTP, Network Time Protocols, IMAP4, Internet Message Access Protocols. Okay, the message, whatever you are accessing by using the internet, and HTTPS, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, secure, right? This also. Now, what do we mean by the DNS? DNS, the TCP IP network speaks there with has utilizing their IP addresses. Okay, you all always know, I have already told you about that. TCP and IP network protocols is TCP IP layers, basically TCP IP protocols basically uses some IP addresses. Okay, it would be exceptionally hard for somebody to need to remember the different IP addresses for the host they need to associate with from the organization. Suppose you are the users and you want to access multiple sites. Okay, you want to access the multiple sites. So it is very difficult for you to remember all the IP addresses of these all sites. Okay, all the IP addresses of these all sites, it is very difficult to remembered in my mind or storing these all the informations in your mind. So we use the DNS. A DNS, that is domain name service, make it simpler to recognize a host by area name, that you can recognize any host by using or the their name, area name. Area name in the sense, like you are searching the Google or you are searching the YouTube, then directly you search in the URL box that YouTube, the URL, this YouTube is basically what DNS, right? Domain name service. And you haven't need to remember the IP addresses of YouTube. Okay, so by using the area name or the domain name, you can easily access the site. So it's, or you can also say that this is a space name utilizes word as opposed to number recognizing internet head. Okay, assume you need to interface with the, suppose you want to access this computer TIA sites, okay, web page, you want to access this web page by utilizing your web programs, you would enter this one in the URL http://www.computer.org. okay, in the location bar or whatever you want to search here, that google.com, youtube.com, okay, any sites, tutorialpoint.com, in the location bar to go to the CompTIA web page. This would be a typical name. What is this here? This you are searching basically this CompTIA. This is basically typical name utilized for the numerical IP address. This is basically used for the, we are using the DNS, you are using this DNS name instead of using the IP addresses. Okay, you could utilize this rather. I am not putting this IP addresses, I am using the DNS name, that is the CompTIA, instead of using this IP address rather. However, CompTIA is similar to real collapse. Okay. DNS worker deciphers these addresses. DNS server or the DNS worker, what is the basic working of DNS? What is the basic service provided by DNS? The service is basically that these protocols basically decipher the addresses. Okay, these basically decipher. You are using the CompTIA or the YouTube, they are basically decipher your name to the particular IP addresses. Okay, so this is decipher the address. Your webcam also asks the TCP/IP protocols to approach the DNS worker. Okay, DNS worker for the IP addresses for this one. Like what? Your web program asks the TCP/IP protocols. You need the TCP/IP protocols, whatever the protocols you want to use, that basically approach this DNS worker for IP addresses. Okay, at the point when program gets the location, what location? Receiver's location. It interface with the website. Okay, suppose you are entering this http://tutorialpoints, http://www.tutorialpoints.com. Then it basically fetches to the internet and they are going to match that. Is it validate or not? Or is it authentic or not? They are using the IP address, they are fetching the IP address of that particular website. And when they recollect all the data, DNS when recollects all the data and all the IP addresses of that particular site, then it display the contents of that particular site. Okay, and this is basically that. At that point when program gets the location, it interface with the website to recall the DNS represent domain name system or the service, and the DNS worker makes the interpretation of the space names into the their IP addresses. Okay, this is basically that IP addresses. What is the protocols basically used for the transferring the data from one port to another or one place to another place? That is basically known as the network protocols. And what is the role of the DNS? This is all this one. Okay. Read these all protocols by yourselves. And if you have any problems regarding this topic, then you please comments in the comment section box. Okay, thank you.